Connie Martinson, Tox Books. Robert Frost, the poet, wrote, "Two roads diverge in the yellow wood." But what he didn't realize is that when a brother and sister face that two roads, they may go on different sides, but eventually they will come together. This is a story that is written by a brother and sister. It's called Rich Brother, Rich Sister, Two Different Paths to God, Money, and Happiness. My guests are Robert Kiyosaki and Emmy Kiyosaki, who is also known as the Venerable Tenzin Katcho. Am I pronouncing it correctly?
Thank you. And it's Kiyosaki.
Kiyosaki.
Thank you.
And it's published by Vanguard Press. Welcome, welcome, Emmy or Tien. Which name do you prefer?
Tenzin, please.
Tenzin and Robert.
Yes, please.
And truly, your lives did diverge in that yellow wood. I would have to say, Tenzin, you were a bit of a hippie.
Oh, yes, I was.
And your life took you to many places. And then somehow or other, you found revelation with, truly, I would say, the Dalai Lama and Buddhism.
I did, yes, I did. And it became the direction that I wanted to lead my life.
And how did your daughter, Erica, handle all of that?
She came along because she wanted to be with me, but she also sent me an email just a couple days ago saying she so appreciated meeting all these wonderful men that men and other teachers in the community of people that were studying Buddhism.
Aha. Uh-huh. And Robert, your life takes the Marines. I mean,
right.
Well, Tenzin is out there saying, bad war, bad Vietnam. You're there shooting up.
Yes, you know, we're children of the 60s. We were raised in Hawaii. And when the Vietnam War came about, it really polarized the nation. There were people pro-war, people anti-war. There was a draft back then. And our mom and dad went to the Peace Corps. She was anti-war, and my brother and I went to war. So yeah. I joined the Marine Corps. I flew helicopters out there. I went twice.
Well, wait a minute, not only that, but you were in a plane crash, everybody else, but suddenly the pilot, who's your close friend, wasn't coming up.
Right, we went down in the off the South China Sea. We had an engine failure. We had, I believe, five men on board, and we're armed with rockets and machine guns, and so we're pretty heavy, and we came straight down. And the aircraft sinks very rapidly, and my co-pilot almost never came up.
Yeah.
So I still remember to this day, it's one of these moments burned in my mind. I can still see the water coming up over my feet. I'm going, oh my God, you know. And the reason that's important is I think so many times people take life for granted.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, we go, oh, we'll do it tomorrow,
yeah.
We'll do it next year or something. But at that moment, when I saw that water coming up and the aircraft's rocking and it's exploding and the blades coming through, you know, I had to ask myself, is this it?
Yeah.
Is this the last moment? And it was a very valuable experience because I've learned to appreciate life and live it to the fullest. And I think that's the big lesson.
We're on the other side of, because this whole book is really, but on the other side. Tenzin was there in a way looking into what is life, what is death, and the philosophical points of view until you yourself had to face the diagnosis of cancer.
That's right. I faced cancer, and then the big one, my big lessons really came when I had the heart disease, because with bad insurance, my out-of-pocket cost last year was over $22,000. And Robert very generously just came forward to help me, but he didn't pay the entire bill. He said, we need to look at how we can change the situation so that I pay a little more attention to the basic needs that need to be covered in my life.
And it is a different, really, point of view for the expression, mind your own business.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And Robert's whole, really, I suppose, part of your claim to fame is rich dad, poor dad. And I thought it was interesting that the poor dad was your biological father, the rich dad was your friend's father.
Right, and my whole life, starting from about the age of 38, is I could see this financial demise, this financial catastrophe we're in today. I could see it coming.
Yeah.
And this was, what, 30 years ago, let's say. And at that point, I kind of found my own mission in life, and that was to become a teacher like my poor dad.
Yeah.
But I teach people what my rich dad taught me. You know, since we don't teach much about money at school, today we have not only a national, but we have a worldwide crisis of people without money.
And without knowledge.
And without knowledge.
Yeah.
And so that's why when my sister had heart disease and she's not paid by His Holiness the Dalai Lama, she has to be a nun full-time and work part-time to cover her expenses. So heart disease just threw her into the category of wiped out financially. Yeah. So I said, well, I don't like to just give people money. Mm-hmm. I went to Sunday school and I learned to teach people to fish, not give them fish.
You know who believes in that? I don't know if your paths have crossed with Muriel Siebert.
Right.
Yeah, Muriel has been trying to get schools to teach high school kids about having a checking account, having credit cards, how you use them.
Yes, you need to go a lot further than that because there's a lot more sophistication.
Yeah.
You know, it's not credit cards, it's not checking accounts that's the problem, it's a lack of financial education. Mm-hmm. And it's intentional. My father was a PhD in education, head of education, but he always said, well, I'm not interested in money, money is not that important. But that's kind of unrealistic in today's world.
Yeah.
And today, you know, so many people are losing their jobs, their homes, their retirements, their kids' savings.
And they didn't save. And even if they saved, if they were in some banks, they have been wiped out.
Well, not only that is, if you did save, look at the interest rate environment we're in today, it's less than 1%.
Yeah.
And soon, with Bernanke printing trillions of dollars, we're going to have hyperinflation pretty soon. Yeah. So the savers are going to get wiped out anyway.
Yeah, it's going to be like Germany before World War II and I.
Weimar Republic, absolutely. Reichsbank.
Yeah. Yes.